number of people seeking sickness benefits soared in every UK constituency last year, with claims rising by a third in affluent areas.
Well, experts have warned that mental health is deteriorating nationwide, with Britain only getting sicker. Joining us now is Rachael Walker from Policy in Practice, an analytics company working with councils and the government. Rachael, how bad is the situation? Because, I mean, look, I'm here sort of between advert breaks, quietly coughing with a box of tissues by my side here, and I've turned up to work.
Well done. What a hero.
I'm getting my medal.
She's
when
amazing,
we come
isn't
off
she?
Air, I know. But, you know, there is a crisis out there. Something has definitely changed when it comes to people's levels of industry ever since COVID, when we're all locked up in our houses and a few people thought, God, I'd rather do this than have to go to the office. How much is this impacting our economy? And how much is this impacting the good functioning of public services?
Those are great questions. Thank you for having me on. It's in terms of how this is impacting the economy, obviously the more people that we have in the workforce, the better it is for local, regional and national economies. The information, data and evidence that we explore at Policy in Practice doesn't suggest necessarily that people are comfortable at home, but the information and data that we look at suggests that people are not getting the treatment that they're entitled to or should be receiving that prevents short-term illnesses becoming longer-term illnesses. The answer to that is obviously healthcare rather than the welfare system. And the welfare system, meanwhile, ought to provide a level of financial resilience for people to prevent a short-term illness becoming a longer-term illness, because we know that the impact of poverty and the links with physical and mental ill health are very well established. So there are a number of factors at play here. A, yes, people are getting sicker. Whilst they are in short-term sickness, we know that they're not able to access NHS support in the timely way that they were, say, several years ago. Coming out of the pandemic, we know that waiting lists are longer, which is then having a knock-on effect. Short-term illnesses are becoming long-term illnesses, and people, whilst on long-term sick, do not have the financial resilience through the welfare system to prevent them becoming even sicker as a result of living on low incomes.
Yeah, well, I mean, sickness benefit, Rachael, is obviously important for people who are genuinely sick. The worry here is last year we shelled out £66 billion on sickness benefits. This year, £91 billion. So it is rocketing at an alarming rate. And of course, the elephant in the room is how many of these people who say, I'm very sick and I need benefits, are telling the truth. We know it's not all of them. That is the problem. We believe the furlough scheme may have created something of a work-shy nation. That is what we're asking our audience today. But what I'd like to ask you is, how do you account for the fact that apparently, I mean, maybe it's inherent in what I've just been saying, but apparently the most interesting factor of these new statistics is that sickness benefit is rocketing in affluent areas, Tory heartland areas. How do you account for that?
I mean, illness is the great leveller, really, in terms of people's resilience to illness isn't necessarily based on the amount where they live and what constituency they're in. But we do see that, you know, as more people, there are national indicators to suggest that as a nation, we are getting sicker. Now, that could be...
getting sicker. That's the problem, isn't it? Are we getting sicker or are we saying we're getting sicker? I mean, the number of people who say I've got mental health issues is soaring. Now, I'm not undermining mental health issues or indeed any health issues, but we all know the problem here is a lot of people are lying. They're swinging the lead, they're lazy. They don't fancy going to work.
I mean, this is where the DWP's work capability assessments come in, and should that system be in place well enough, they ought to be able to determine whether or not somebody is telling the truth or whether or not they are genuinely sick, alongside being able to get medical information from GPs and from NHS consultants, for example. So whereas, you know, absolutely, I'm sure there are a minority of claimants who are not necessarily telling the truth. In general, the system is there and there are systems and checks and balances in place to ensure that those work capability assessments and the assessments that to get onto disability benefits or ill health benefits are robust enough to make sure that people are claiming money that they are entitled to from the welfare state.
The difficulty is, though, if getting a sick note means going to a GP, if anyone can get a GP's appointment these days, especially if it's for mental health. If you sit in front of a doctor and you said to a doctor, I've got really bad anxiety, I've got depression, I struggle to get out of bed every day, I'm having suicidal thoughts, going to work keeps me awake at night, I feel like I'm about to burn out, da-da-da-da-da. I don't think there are many GPs out there who are going to say, well, prove it, I'm not going to write your sick note.
Absolutely. I mean, that's their medical judgment, I guess. And I'm sure that there are other factors other than people just stating that to their GP. You know, there are mental health assessments that GPs run, and there are other certain qualifying factors, certainly for a sick note. And, you know, but also if somebody was to present with that level of symptoms, it would suggest that they're in a particularly acute mental health crisis. And I would expect the system to then step in, as it's been designed to do so, to help people in that situation.
Very quick last question, Rachael. Thank you very much for joining us. Are you satisfied that our system, in terms of people who claim sickness benefit, mental health benefit, is robust enough?
No, ultimately no. There are cracks in the system, and we know that the government is working towards making changes to that. Whether those changes will end up with more people claiming ill health benefits or fewer people, we're not quite sure yet. We do believe that there will be more people claiming ill health benefits as things like NHS waiting times continue to be longer than they ought to be to help people with their health. Meanwhile, the system ought to provide enough of a safety net that living on benefits is not more of a triggering factor for ill health. Yeah. We know that the links between poverty and ill health are well established. The welfare state at the moment doesn't necessarily provide enough financial resilience for people to be able to focus on their health and to not deteriorate any further as a result of living on a very low income.
Rachael, great to talk to you. That was Thanks, Rachael Walker there.
Thank you.